In 1951, the Talyllyn Railway was much the same as it had been since 1865. For over 80 years, the same little engines with the same four coaches had trundled up and down the valley. Even in the first year of preservation, it was almost exclusively Dolgoch who would rumble up the valley track with no one to hurry or hold her back but herself. Life was as it had always been. A decade later, however, everything had changed. There were three new steam engines, pulling heavier trains than ever before, and demand continued to grow. The Talyllyn was at the risk of becoming a victim of its own wildly unexpected success. By the early 60s, the cry went out, "We need another engine." And they would get one. It would just take a little under 30 years. Imagine you're a fledgling preservation society, one with very little money and very big plans. The Talyllyn had been lucky. The nearby Corris Railway shared a track gauge and similar sizing. Douglas had been a gift, but the options available to the preservation pioneers were limited. So they took a plain sheet of paper and decided to see what they could make themselves. There's a whole story about what could have been and what might have happened. It's a story for another day. What really happened was that the Talyllyn got lucky. Again. Three Andrew Barclay light class engines had found their way to Ireland to work on the Bordnamona Railway. Built to 3 foot gauge, they had been mothballed after just a few years' work. All three would survive in some form. Number 2 going to the Stradbally Woodland Railway, number 3 to the Giant's Causeway and Bushmills Railway, and number 1 was destined for Wales. A volunteer at what would become the Welsh Highland Heritage Railway had an option to buy number 1, but in January 1969, the option was about to run out. They telephoned Chief Engineer John Bate and told him the details of the engine, and that it would cost £210. Sight unseen, John bought the engine. What he bought wasn't an engine to be restored, but a kit of parts to be utilised. John Bate developed his new design for number 7 to make the best use of what was there. The boiler, the cylinders, the motion and wheels would all be reused. The tanks were developed to allow for a full round trip if necessary. The chimney was a lucky buy from Dunorwick Quarry, and the fairly spectacle plates were donated by the Festiniog Railway. But what was everyone else doing whilst number 7 slowly took shape? The Preservation Society were choosing a name for their new engine. Suggestions at the time included James Swinton Spooner, after the surveyor, Merion, after the county, Tom Rolt, after, well, Tom Rolt, Cader Idris, after the mountain, Earl of North Esk, after the Society's first president, and Irish Pete. It was Irish Pete that won the ballot in 1970, the name having been chalked on the loco side when it had arrived at Wharf. The need for another engine, however, had faded away. Three train working meant the heavy trains became lighter, and the engines were slowly fettled to perfection by the team at Pendray. Irish Pete was worked on when there was nothing else to do, but as anyone who has visited Pendray will tell you, there's always something to do. Remember, this was when the Talyllyn was forging boldly ahead to Nantgwernal. This was the time when Talyllyn was rebuilt, then Douglas, then Dolgoch, then Talyllyn again. And honestly, with five engines now reliable performers on less demanding traffic, the railway didn't need a sixth. But nobody had needed the Talyllyn, and look at what happened to that. So it was, nearly 20 years later, in 1988, the council resolved to complete number 7. There was plenty to do to transform the kit of parts into a functional locomotive, but perhaps most important was a final decision on her name. In 1989, at the AGM, the options were as follows: Cader Idris, Earl of North Esk, Irish Pete, Nantgwernal, Prince William, and Tom Rolt. This time, a system of transferable votes was used. And this time, Tom Rolt won. The naming ceremony was set for May the 6th, 1991. Number 7 was steam tested 3 days before, and ran with paint that had barely dried. The kit of parts that was Bordnamona number 1 was no more. But Tom Rolt was finally finished. she has a lot of power and can haul the heaviest trains. In 1996, Tom Rolt's equivalent was written into the Railway series by Christopher Audrey, named after their line's engineer, Ivo Hugh. Unfortunately, this was to be the last story for many years, and the last Scarlowe Railway tale ever. The impact of this new little engine would never be seen. Tom Rolt is a very different story. As designed, she was the perfect engine for the halcyon days of the 60s, and has more than proven herself since then. In many ways, she's the perfect Talyllyn engine, free-steaming and easy to maintain, able to haul whatever is asked of her at whatever speed is required. The practical attitude that went into every part of her design has made her popular indeed amongst crews and enthusiasts alike. Over the years, Tom Rolt has proven herself just as interesting as her counterparts. There's nothing quite like her anywhere. Tom Rolt has only ever run on Talyllyn metals. In the last 30 years, she's never run anywhere else. No one could have predicted in 1951 that 40 years later, the Talyllyn would gain a new steam engine, bespoke designed to suit to the needs of a thriving railway. This is where she was built to run. And she does it very well indeed.